In this video, we will be setting up user provisioning with Azure to sync your users over into the SolarWinds Service Desk. To start our configuration, we will start in the SolarWinds Service Desk, and we will need to grab two different things. We will need to grab your account URL, as well as a security token to handle authentication. So to get our account URL, the first thing that we'll do is we'll click on the Setup menu and click on Account, and then we'll click on Account Summary. And we can copy our account URL. Next, to get our security token, we are going to go to our user list by clicking on Users and Groups, then clicking Users, and I'm going to search for my user account. So once I find my account, I will just click on my account name. Next, I'm going to click Actions towards the upper right corner and generate JSON web token. Once the token generates, I will click Copy. Now that I have my account URL, as well as my JSON web token, we can move over into Azure to handle the rest of the configuration. So now that we are in Azure, if you followed the instructions for the single sign-on video, you already have the Azure Enterprise application added for SolarWinds Service Desk. If you have not followed that video, you will need to go to the Enterprise Applications and add the SolarWinds Service Desk Enterprise app. From within the SolarWinds Service Desk Enterprise application, the first place that we'll be going to is the Provisioning tab under the Manage section. Once we click on Provisioning, the next thing that we'll click on is Get Started. And once we are able to modify the dropdown for provisioning mode, we will select Automatic. The next thing that we'll be doing is moving down to our admin credentials, and this is where we're going to enter in the things that we copied from the Service Desk. So in our secret token box, we will paste the JSON web token. And in our tenant URL, that is where we will paste our account URL, starting with https://. Once you have both the tenant URL and the secret token entered, you'll want to click Test Connection to make sure that everything is working properly. Once you see the green check mark, you are good to go, and you'll want to hit Save as the next step. So once you have saved your credentials, the next thing that you'll want to do is actually refresh your entire browser tab. And then from there, we'll be going to the Settings menu and we'll expand that. In the Settings section, you'll want to check the box to send an email notification when a failure occurs. And then you'll also want to provide a notification email address where you would like to receive those alerts in case of a failure. In this case, I will be entering my email address so that I receive those notifications. Once you have entered in your notification email address, again, hit Save. And the next step will be to turn the provisioning status to on. By turning the provisioning status to on and hitting Save, Azure is going to reach out to your instance of SolarWinds Service Desk and pull in the list of user roles or user assignments in the next section. Once you've turned the provisioning status on, we can then go back a menu by clicking the X. And the next place that we'll be going is Users and Groups. Now that we are in the Users and Groups menu, we will want to assign any and all users that we want to provision over into the Service Desk. To do that, we will click Add User Group. Now, in this instance of Azure, we are not able to use group management, but if you are paying for a premium subscription with Azure, you will be able to use groups to handle your assignments. So in this particular example, we will be selecting an example user and then also selecting their role. So you'll click None Selected under the User section and select your user. Once you've selected your user, the next thing that you will need to do is select a role for that user to be provisioned into. So I'll click None Selected under Select a Role. And this will give you the list of roles from your instance of SolarWinds Service Desk. This will include the out-of-the-box roles as well as any custom roles that you have created. For this example, we're going to select Administrator. And now that we've got both our user and its role selected, we'll click Assign. Once you've added your user, you'll be able to verify that they are listed there with the correct role assigned. In this example, we can see that Bob Smith will be provisioned over as the administrator. You will want to do this with all users that you have in your Active Directory, in which you want to assign and provision into the service desk. Again, if you have a premium subscription for Azure, you will be able to use groups instead of just individual users. In order to assign a group instead of a user, you will follow the same process, but instead of selecting a single user, you will select the group that you want to provision and the role that you'll want that entire group to provision over as. So now that we have one person assigned here, again, you will want to make sure that you assign the rest of your users. But the next step will be to go back to our provisioning menu. And from here, we are going to click Restart Provisioning. And once we click Restart Provisioning, it'll give us a second confirmation here. And that is going to restart the provisioning sync cycle and attempt to start pushing any assigned users. The initial configuration will take approximately 30 minutes. And then within the next hour, you should start seeing users provisioning into your account.